Well, good afternoon, everyone. I want to thank you for being here at today's announcement. Before we begin, I'd like to acknowledge we are gathered on Treaty 2 territory, and Manitoba is located on the treaty territories and ancestral lands of the Anishinaabeg, Anishinaabeg, Dakota Oyete, Dene Suliné, and Nehithawak nations. We acknowledge Manitoba is located on the homeland of the Red River Métis, and that northern Manitoba includes lands that were and are the ancestral lands of the Inuit. We respect the spirit and intent of treaties and treaty making and remain committed to working in partnership with First Nations, Inuit, and Métis people in that spirit of truth, reconciliation, and collaboration. I'm Andrew Micklefield, the MLA for Rossmere, and I'm pleased to be joined here today by my colleague, Minister Kelvin Goertzen, and also Police Board Chair Markus Chambers. With us as well, representatives from the RCMP, Superintendent Scott McMurchie, Acting Officer in Charge, Criminal Operations, D Division, and WPS Deputy Chief Gene Bowers. We thank you for joining us here today. Now at this time, I would like to invite Minister Goertzen to come and make today's announcement.
Thank you very much, Andrew. Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you for being here, braving the heat this afternoon in Winnipeg. I want to thank my friend and colleague, Andrew Micklefield, for emceeing this afternoon. I know he is a tremendous advocate, both for his community and for Winnipeg more broadly and the safety within the city of Winnipeg. Also, my friend and colleague, Deputy Mayor Chambers, Chair of the Winnipeg Police Board, and especially representatives from law enforcement, Winnipeg Police Service, and the RCMP, who have joined us as well. Each and every day, they are doing difficult work. And we know that these are difficult times across Canada, around North America. We are seeing the increase of violent crime. This has now been a trend for many months across North America, and governments are responding, and our government has responded strongly as well, with things that we have control over in a provincial justice jurisdiction. We've increased resources in a number of different areas, not the least of which is a new integrated unit to go after those who are violent offenders and might have outstanding warrants. We've worked with the federal government to look for new and tougher bail restrictions. We've had some success there. We think there's more work to do, but we're grateful for the proposed changes that have been brought forward by the federal government. Some of you will remember, because you might have been here a few months ago, or maybe it was a few weeks ago, where we announced 7 new Crown attorneys specifically dedicated to guns, violent crime, and dealing with those who are charged with those offenses. Since that time, I'm pleased to report 6 of the 7, I understand, positions have been filled, so that unit within Crown Prosecutions is doing the important work that it does. But we know that there is more work to do. And as we do things like create an integrated unit to go after those who are violent offenders, that unit is monitoring dozens and dozens of individuals and has arrested many individuals. So we're seeing the impact of that. There are more arrests. Our prison population numbers are increasing because we know that we have to ensure that those who are most dedicated to committing crime in our communities are faced by those who are dedicated from stopping that crime. And those include, not limited to, but certainly include Crown attorneys in the province of Manitoba who do tremendous work. But because of the fact that there are more arrests and because there are pressures in terms of timelines when it comes to cases, and because we know we need to ensure that those who are committing violent crimes in our communities are off of the streets, we know we need more Crown attorneys. So today I'm pleased to announce that the province is investing approximately $3.5 million for the addition of 25 new Crown attorneys, prosecutors in the province of Manitoba. This will be the largest single increase of Crown attorneys in our province in nearly 2 decades. It's a significant response to a significant problem. I also know that our Crown Attorneys, while doing really important work, are doing really difficult work. I know in talking to those who are involved in the branch that there are workload issues, that that can cause stress, that there can be mental health pressure as a result, not only of the work, but the nature of the work that they do in dealing with very violent offenders and trying to ensure that they are provided a punishment that meets the crime. So these additional 25 Crown Attorneys, we believe, will help not only when it comes to the workload issues, certainly help when it comes to moving cases more quickly through the court process, but most importantly, will help in getting those who are violent offenders off of our streets. There's more things to do. As I've said before, the criminal justice system is like a chain, and every link in that chain needs to be strong. Our Crown Attorneys are an important part of that link, as are our courts, as are our police, as are other elements of it, and there'll be further announcements on that. But for today, the announcements of a historic increase of Crown Attorneys by 25, now more than 200 Crown Attorneys in Manitoba, once those positions are filled, we think is an important step in ensuring safety in Winnipeg and throughout Manitoba. Thank you again for the opportunity to be here. I know there's a couple of more speakers that we want to hear from, and then I think there'll be an opportunity for questions.
Thank you, Minister. I'm now going to invite Police Board Chair Markus Chambers to come and make some remarks.
Thank you, Andrew. I hope you can tell the difference between Minister Goertzen and myself. We are both wearing blue suits and blue ties and brown shoes. There is a distinction, though. I want to thank Minister Goertzen and the province of Manitoba for inviting me to share a few words today at this announcement. Public safety is felt in the utmost way at the local level. Municipal governments are responsible for the funding of community safety strategies that are carried out through a wide range of services, including policing. It takes robust consultation and genuine collaboration to create, enhance, and sustain public safety. Partnerships with the city and the province will forge responsive outcomes that address the rise in violent crimes that we are currently witnessing. Adequate staffing in the province of Manitoba Prosecution Service is of the utmost importance for effective functioning of our criminal justice system. The Manitoba Prosecution Services plays a vital role in upholding the rule of law, supporting public safety, and securing justice for victims. First and foremost, sufficient staffing levels are necessary to handle caseloads efficiently. The prosecutor's workload is substantial, with numerous cases to review, to analyze, and prepare for trial. Insufficient staffing can lead to delays in court proceedings, resulting in the prolonged waiting periods for victims, defendants, and witnesses. Adequate staffing levels also allows for timely resolution of cases, enhancing public trust in the criminal justice system. In early November of 2022, the province announced a joint warrant unit to address the rise in violent crime by repeat offenders. The addition of staff within the prosecution services enables timely prosecution of criminal offenses and supports the law enforcement efforts to keep our streets safe. The third piece of this comprehensive and effective change will be bail reform. And I know that this is being championed by provincial justice ministers across Canada, supported by the Canadian Association of Chiefs of Police. Skilled and experienced prosecutors are essential for presenting compelling arguments, examining witnesses, and presenting evidence in court. They possess the expertise needed to navigate complex legal issues and seek appropriate penalties for offenders. A fully staffed office allows for specialization and expertise in different areas of criminal law. Some cases may require specific knowledge and experience, such as white-collar crimes, domestic violence, or drug-related offenses. Having a diverse range of specialized experiences ensures prosecutors can handle a wide range of cases effectively. As I conclude my remarks today on this timely announcement, I applaud the province of Manitoba for enhancing the Manitoba Prosecution Services. It is crucial for the effective and efficient administration of justice. Adequate staffing levels, as mentioned, contribute to timely resolution of cases, improve quality of prosecutions, and the development of specialized expertise, all of which are essential for the fair and functionality of our criminal justice system. Thank you.
I want to thank you for those remarks, and this does conclude the formal portion of this event. I want to thank everybody for coming out today. There will now be Q&A available, and then we will invite the representatives up for a group photo. Any questions?